If you have been following this channel, then you know I've released a video on GPT-4o, which is a multimodal model from OpenAI. This model is capable of receiving textual input, images as input, and also audio data as input, hence the name multimodal model. So in this tutorial, I'll be teaching you how to prompt this model using images, text and audio data as well. I'll be taking you through from scratch how to implement this using the Python programming language. We are not going to use any other language. We are doing everything in Python. So grab a seat and get your cup of coffee and let's roll. So as usual, these are the files you will need for this particular tutorial. The first thing first, you will need an OpenAI API key. So inside the this.env file, just paste your OpenAI API key right here. And if you don't have one, just open your browser and just type in openai.com/api/ and hit enter on this. Right here, just select start building. And this will open up your OpenAI account. So you have to make sure first you have account with OpenAI. So over here, click on API keys and you can just hit create and you will create your API key right here. So over here, you can give it a name or you can just hit create and create your API key. So that's all. When you create a key, make sure you copy it and back in your code, just make sure right after OpenAI API key, you paste in your API key here. I'll revoke mine immediately after this particular tutorial, so don't even try to use it. Just go get your own API key and everything will be fine. Okay, so apart from API key, the next thing you'll be needing is I'll be sending you guys this code and the images as well. We'll be using this image and we'll see if this model will be able to solve the math in this particular image. Also, I've recorded a short audio about the intro for this particular video, which I'll also send into this model to transcribe it and also tell me what is going on in this particular audio. For the requirements, all you need to install is OpenAI. So just have to do pip install OpenAI, and that's all. That's the only thing we'll be using in this particular tutorial. If there is any other thing you need to install, I'll tell you before this tutorial ends. Okay, so in our main.py here, the first thing we'll do is to import OpenAI from OpenAI. So just have to write OpenAI from OpenAI, you are going to import OpenAI. And then we also go ahead and import .env. So from .env, we import load.env. Alright, as usual, we import OS as well. Okay, and this is all. So this is all our imports we need for this particular tutorial. First of all, I'll also instantiate the model I'm going to use. So I'll just say model, and this is equal to GPT-4.0. All right, so I'll be using the GPT-4o model, and that particular model is a multimodal model. So we are using that particular model. Right from there, we'll read in our API key. So I'll just call it client. And this client is equal to OpenAI. And inside here, we'll get our OpenAI API key. So just type in so API underscore key, and this is equal to we'll use OS and load.env to get our API key. So before that, I can just type in load.env here to get all the environmental keys for us. So this right here will be equal to os.getenv. And inside here, you have to type in the name of your API key. So over there, the name we've given it is what? OpenAI API key, or caps. So with this out of the way, we've now imported our libraries. We've loaded in the model we want, and we've also loaded in our API key. The next thing now we'll do is to test this model. So we'll start with the text inputs because we are all familiar with these models receiving tests and also giving us back some tests. So we start with that, and for that I'll just copy the boilerplate code we need for test and paste it right here. All right, so let me close this, and this is the boilerplate code we need. So I'll just explain this for you guys. So we said completion is equal to client.chat.completion.create. Okay, so we are just doing a chat completion. kind of things. We'll give this model test and it will complete whatever we want for us. Whatever tasks we want, this model will go ahead and complete it for us. So we are using clients here because our API key is attached to a variable called clients. With this, we can be able to get our API key. And also we instantiated our model right here. So we can just do model is equal to our particular model. And in this case, we are using GPT-4.0. All right. Right in here, you can see we have a message, and this message is a list, and this list contains some dictionaries, okay? So in message, we have a row, and the row is whatever row you are giving to this particular model. So over here, we are telling this model that you are a helpful assistant that helps with my math homework. So this assistant helps you with your math homework. And the content you are now giving it to solve, or the problem you are giving it to solve is, could you solve 20 multiplied by 5? Okay, so that is a question we are giving to this model. And if everything works great, it should print out the answer for us. And we are getting that from message.content. So let's kind of run this and try this out. Let me even comment, put a comment here. So this is our text use case. Or textual use case. All right, so I'll just kind of run this. Okay, and here we go, guys. So you can see straightforward is that giving us the answer 20 divided by what is it 20? What is in the question? The question says 20 multiplied by 5. So the answer we are expecting here should be 100. And let's see what it has given us. Okay, so it has given us 100. 20 is it multiplied by 5 or 25 times gives us 100. So this model is doing a fantastic job. It's solving the math problem, even though this is a very simple problem we can all solve. Going forward, we'll give it a much complex problem to solve. So let's move on. And we are not going to waste much time with the text because we are all used to these language models, using them with text and so on. The main focus is about giving it audio file to transcribe and also answer questions based on the audio file, and also finally give it an image to perform tasks based on the image. I think that's the newest use case we should dive deeper into, and not the text aspect, because we are used to the textual aspect. All right, so I'll comment this so that we move on to the next part. And then for the next part, we'll go to the audio aspect of it. So I'll just write here audio use case. Let me give you some space between them. And for the audio use case, I'll still need to paste in the boilerplate code we need for it. I think it's pretty much the same as the textual use case, but with the audio, we need to do some couple of things. Okay. So with the audio use case, first, we need your path to the audio. Okay. So this model has to accept audio, and there is something we need to do. You need to pre-process this audio to transcribe it and get the text. Okay, so we convert the audio speech to a text, and then this model can take this text and answer questions based on them. Okay, so we have to first give the path to our audio, and the name of our audio here is test.mp3. So it's kind of the same name here. I think this is lowercase mp3. It should work, but let me just change it. So audio path test.mp3, and then transcription is equal to client.audio. So here we are using the OpenAI Whisper model to transcribe this audio. And what I mean by transcribing the audio is just converting the audio to text, so speech to text kind of thing that we are doing here. So Whisper will now transcribe this text and save this text into a file for us. Then moving on, we can just read this audio file which has been converted to text and perform some operations on them. Okay, so I think even before that, let me play the audio and let's see what this audio contain. In this video, I'll teach you how to use the GPT-4.0 multimodal model. So since this model is a multimodal model, I'll teach you how to feed it with text, images and audio files as well. Ready to do it? Let's get right into it. Okay, so you can all hear this audio, and it's nothing but just some simple audio I've recorded. In this video, I'm going to teach you how to use the multimodal model. That's what I've recorded in this audio. It doesn't hold anything much. Okay, so we are transcribing the audio, and over here, we are feeding the audio into the model, okay? And what we are telling this model is that you are generating a transcript or summary. So we are generating a summary for this particular audio as a markdown. Okay, so over here we say, okay, you are generating a transcript summary. Create a summary of the provided transcription. And we are saying transcription here because we know the audio file needs to be transcribed into text. Okay, so that's why we are not feeding the audio directly into the model. We are transcribing the audio. That's what you need to know, that we are transcribing the audio, and then we are feeding the text output we are getting from that audio into the model for the model to work on. So the model is now going to provide a summary on that particular audio for us. So it will give us an output as a text as well. So they say the audio transcription is, this is going to be printed out. We are using F string, and then it will give us the text or the summary of our transcribed audio. So over here, we are still printing it out, and I'll run it so that we see how well it's transcribing and summarizing this particular audio. Boom, and guys, here we go. So you can see it has done a very good job. So this is the summary. In this video, the presenter will teach viewers how to use GPT-4o multimodal model. Perfect. This is perfect, guys. This is exactly what I said I'm going to teach you, and it has gotten that exactly that. The tutorial will what cover how to input text, images, and audio files into the model. The presenter encourages viewers to get ready and dive into the learning process. Exactly what I said. Nothing less, nothing more. This is exactly what I said in this particular audio, and you can see it right here. You can see how everything has been summarized perfectly. This model is working great, guys. No cap, this model is just good. So we are doing exactly that. We are feeding in text, we are feeding in images. The next thing we are going to do is to feed in images. So we have already fed in some text and audio files. So let's go straight into it and see how we can feed this model some images. Let me close this up. So now we are done with the audio. You just need to transcribe the audio and then feed in the text. Let me comment that. And our final use case here is with images. So I'll put that here. I'll call it image use case. And I'll just have to comment this. And that's the final code I'm going to paste here. All right, so this is for our image use case. All right, so first we are importing base64 because we have to encode this our image into base64 format before feeding into the model. So it's not like we are also giving the model directly our image, but we have to encode this image before sending into the model. So for that, we are importing base64 right here, and we are specifying the path to our image. So if you could see, here is the image. This is the image. Let me zoom it. And this image contains some mathematical problems. So we have 4x, we have 2x minus 10, 3x minus 8 in a triangle, and we want this model to find the result for us. Okay, so let's get into it and see how this model solves it, and then we'll also validate it by solving it, because it's straightforward. It's a simple mathematical problem. Okay, so as I said earlier on, we first have this function here, and this function is just reading in our image and encoding it in base64 format, and that's all. So that's what we are doing, and from there we are feeding this image into our model to answer questions on the model. Okay, so it returns as our base64 encoded image, and over here you can see we have our client.completion.create. We specify the model. And this is the prompt I've given it. You are a helpful math assistant that responds in markdown. So we want the answer to be in a markdown format. That means one after the other. And also I give it that, okay, help solve the math problem in this image. So that's all I want. I want it to solve any mathematical problem it sees in that particular image for me. Also, guys, we can specify image URL. So in case you are having a image online, you can specify the image URL online for it to work for you, but I have this image locally on my machine, so I've defined the path to that particular image. So right from there we are just printing the result. So let's see how best this model can solve this mathematical problem for us. I'll quickly run this because this is straightforward as well. Alrighty, so here we go, guys. It has returned something for us. Let's go through it and validate it. Let's see if it's correct. Before, and I've solved this, and I know x, the value of x should be is it 22? So let's just go through it. So to solve for x in the given triangle, we need to use the fact that the sum of the interior angle is equal to 180. I think that's correct. We all know that. The angles given in the triangle are 2x minus 10, so it has listed them. Can I open the image in another page so that you guys can see? Okay, I think the terminal have blocked it, so I can just do it like this. So these are the angles given in the image, 4x, 2x minus 10, and 3x minus 8. So this is the image we are trying to solve the problem for. Okay, I can raise my terminal a little bit, and now let's look at how it solves it. Okay, so we can set up the equation as follows. So this is the equation that's brought us 2x minus, yeah, it's just adding everything up and equating it to 180, nothing new. And now let's combine like them. So right from here, 2x with 3x and what, 4x can add up to each other to get you 9x. And then you can just add these ones to 183 because they are with negative sign here. And when they cross over to the equal root sign, they have to be positive. So you have to add them to 180 and you will get 198. And over here, just use 9 to divide this to get x as 22. So it has done a great job and you can see how it has solved it. Now let's go through it. So x is equal to 22. And it has even given you, it has stated that, okay, to verify this, you can substitute the value of s, which is 22, back into the expression for the angles, okay? So it has also done that job for you. And now checking the sum, it gives you 180. That means your answer is correct. So the sum indeed divided by 180, confirming that our solution is correct. Therefore, x is equal to 180. Guys, this is the future. You can see you just throw in an image, you throw in a math question, and this multimodal model is able to solve this particular problem for you. This is great. This is just nice. And in upcoming videos, we will see how we can run this model live by just saying things to it, and it will be returning answers to us directly straight from our live webcam. So that's like a video feed. So this is how I want you guys to picture video feed. The video feed is nothing but just images stacked together to give you a video file. So we'll be doing that, and I'll also be making a tutorial on how to run this live from your webcam and be talking to it as your personal assistant. If you like that, just give me a thumbs up. Also, share this particular tutorial with whomever may like it or whomever may learn from it. Whoever you know this will benefit, just share it with them. And up until then, I will see you guys in the next coming tutorial. The code and everything will be on my GitHub repository, so make sure you can leverage it and also get your hands dirty with it. Thanks for watching once again, and I will see you in my next tutorial.